All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to another Deepvue tutorial. Today we'll be talking through my trade execution market dashboard that I built here in the Deepvue platform. This just allows me to streamline my daily routine, stay on top of the top ideas of the day, as well as stay in tune with situational awareness, getting a sense of what my portfolio is doing, as well as what the market leadership is doing. So here in Deepvue, you can create your specialized dashboard. I've got one for kind of market analysis. This is my trade execution one here, which I'll walk through in just a second. Then I've got one for position sizing. And basically you can create your ideal trading layout that specifically suits kind of one aspect of your process, one aspect of your trading routine. And for me, you know, this is the one that I use in the morning when I'm looking to enter trades. It's kind of specifically formulated for that. But I've made a previous video about the market monitor dashboard. If you want to check that out, definitely do so. That's a great way to kind of get a sense of what's working in the market. How healthy is the market? What's the trend? And where's the money flowing? Where's the rotation flowing? So if you haven't watched that one yet, I kind of walk through the basics of creating a dashboard as well. So definitely recommend checking that out. You can find that in the link down below in the description, as well as popping up right now. But today we're going to be focused on going through and kind of walking through how I use my trade execution dashboard here in Deepvue. And by the way, if you haven't yet tried Deepvue, highly recommend giving it a shot. We've got a special limited time offer of 2 months for $39 running right now. You can use the link down below the description, as well as popping up right now, to take advantage of that. Highly recommend checking it out, especially if you're a can slim, swing, or position trader. We've worked really hard on this platform, bringing in features that will save you time, help you find those leaders faster, and help you trade and manage those positions that much easier. A lot of specialized indicators, top trader screens that are kind of one click away from Kalamagi, Minervini, Dr. Eric Wish, Oliver Kell, a ton of great ideas that hopefully will save you time and make trading that much easier for you. So definitely check this out and give it a shot using that promotion. So with that said, let's go ahead and walk through my trading execution dashboard. And again, the high level purpose of this specific layout is to streamline my process in the morning, keep me focused on the top ideas that, you know, I've created using my plan, also give me a sense of that situational awareness in the morning. You know, is it a good day in the market? Should I be defensive? Should I be aggressive? This dashboard helps me do that. So first things first, we've got a chart app over here on the right hand side. And very quickly, just because I walked through this last video, you can basically in your dashboard add any of these five existing apps. We'll be adding more, you know, variations in the future, but we've got a charting element, screening element, deep list element, stats table with earnings and sales data, position size calculator. Those are the apps that we have today, but likely when you're watching this, we'll have added even more going out into the future, and are always taking recommendations from our users of useful things that they'd like to see us add to this dashboard. But basically, I've got a charting element here on the right-hand side, and then three different deep lists over here on the left. The charting element I have split into two timeframes, which I did using this layout tool. I've got a daily timeframe on the left, and then on the right-hand side, I've got a 10-minute chart here, which is useful to see kind of those intraday movements and intraday trends. Always looking at the higher time frame key levels. This is what creates the setup, creates the entry tactic, and then this is simply to watch the intraday price action as the stock approaches those levels. I've got volume and RMV. Those are my main two indicators here, as well as my moving averages. I have the 10 EMA in this fade line here. Then I've got my 21 EMA, this darker line. That's my main moving average. If I could only use one, this would be it. And then I have a 42 EMA, kind of twice this 21 EMA down here as well. And then I often also have a 50 SMA loaded up as well to get that kind of longer term trend, as well as be a key level to watch for pullbacks to, as well as trade off of as a stock rebounds, as it forms a base. But again, those are my key moving averages here. Volume and then RMV we have videos on. This is basically a relative measure of what the volatility is. As the stock tightens, this RMV will get closer to zero. as it expands, this will get to 100. So it's a great way to find those tight areas, those spots where you can manage risk really easily and create ideally explosive moves from as a stock moves up from those tight ranges. That's pretty much it for the charting element side. Going over to the left, we've got my focus list for that particular day. I have this set up with my standard column layout, which I can open up and show you. RMV AS rating 1 month. I often screen by these. That's why I like to have them all the way on the left. And then I have my kind of more actionable columns as well. Price percent change today, the last price, the run rate, 20-day DCR volume. These are the main ones that I would be, switching between very early on in the day to see what's moving on volume, as well as price percent change from open. I also use that pretty regularly. And then I've got AS rating 1 month, and you can see the others right here, some more fundamental ones going to the bottom. But these are more during screening, so I can get a sense of also the fundamental picture of the stock. But that is my column layout. Again, I'll often be sorting by this and quickly during the start of the day, see what volume is running ahead of schedule. And that really points you towards those breakouts that can really move and make an impact. Then I've got my existing portfolio as a deep list right underneath that. So this is my focus list, but I always want to make sure I'm keeping an eye on my existing positions to make sure that I'm managing them properly. And also giving myself feedback on, how's my portfolio doing on that particular day? And having that right there underneath my focus list means I don't have to switch between panes. It's just quickly right there for you. You can see they're pretty similar right now, my focus list, as well as my existing positions. Then down here, I've got my leaders list. So again, this provides you with a little bit of situational awareness about, what is the health of the market? How are the strongest stocks performing at that moment? If they're all kind of moving together early on in the session, especially if a particular group is, such as semiconductors, that gives you a sense that, a semiconductor play might work that day. Just, have that increased odds if there's an overall group move supporting it. And similarly, on the flip side, if all cybersecurity names, all cybersecurity, leaders down here are, gapping down or moving down on volume, then maybe, even if a name is set up, it might not be the best day to, take advantage of that opportunity. So really helpful to have a quick view of the leaders to give that overall market perspective. And then, of course, you can always quickly pull up, the QQQ over here in the chart element and, get a sense of how the market is performing, or you can also use this search symbol and, get a sense of, how the market is acting that particular day. And then you can quickly X this out to get back to your standard screen. So that's pretty much it for my trade execution dashboard. Really quick and easy. I'm able to watch my focus list, just tab through really easily. And then also if I want to take a look at my existing positions, I can go ahead and load those up and keep an eye on how my portfolio is performing without having to go my broker and all of that in another tab or another window. So basically this helps keep me organized, keeps me focused on what is my plan, what are my positions doing, what is my focus list doing, how's it performing, and then here I get a quick sense of that portfolio or market awareness, what groups are acting well, what leaders are acting well. And then these, this chart element here, the daily time frame and 10-minute time frame, which sometimes I honestly just leave it on the daily time frame and can switch it quickly with these. This is kind of for execution and actually entering and managing positions. So that's pretty much it for my trade execution dashboard. It might seem simple because that's how I want it. I want to stay as focused as I can and not be distracted by, other stocks that, maybe are up huge, but they weren't in my plan. They weren't in my focus. I want to stay focused on what I can, actually manage, what I'm prepared for, what I've got a plan, position size, stop loss for, all of that. So that's why I have it set up this way. And 100%, if you're somebody who potentially you're more an intraday type trader, you could, instead of having this deep list, this leader's deep list right here, you could X this out and, instead of having a deep list there, you could set up a screen element, which we'll go ahead and expand that. And for instance, you could set up on volume screen or you know, Deepvue leaders. We'll go ahead and add that in and then automatically have that loaded up, sort by percent change today. And then, you know, always having a constant source of ideas. You know, any screen that you have in the platform, anything you can create here, you can have a live updating screen right there for you. So you can watch your focus list, your portfolio, but also get some more ideas, especially if you're a faster term trader and looking to source ideas during the day. So that's a quick run through of my trade execution dashboard. Let me know if you have any questions down below. Leave a like down below if you enjoyed. And definitely go ahead and take advantage, if you haven't yet, of that 2 month for $39 limited time offer. Highly recommend it. Yeah, hopefully this was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions about Deepvue down below, and I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.